हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू टारगेट यूपीसी। बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स हैव बीन आस्किंग मी सर हाउ टू लर्न इन अ बेटर वे, हाउ टू मेमोराइज थिंग्स। दे हैव बीन स्टडिंग फॉर 10 to 12 आवर्स, स्टिल नॉट बीन एबल टू गेट द डिजायर्ड आउटपुट। ऑल दिस 7 स्टेप्स विच आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू इज बेस्ड ऑन माई एक्सपीरियंस विद मोस्ट ऑफ द टॉपर्स ड्यूरिंग माई एमबीबीएस पीरियड, ड्यूरिंग माई यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन एंड थ्रू माई एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ क्लियरिंग यूपीएससी। तो ये सारे जो भी टिप्स मैं बताऊंगा या स्टेप्स मैं बताऊंगा, इट्स बीन ट्राइड एंड टेस्टेड बाई मेनी टॉपर्स। सो मेक श्योर यू वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आर यूट्यूब चैनल। सो इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज शेयर इट ऑल्सो। To start with, one of the major problem among students is they just focus on reading. Bahut sare students aap dekhte hoge, they read for 10 to 12 hours. I had a friend who was into reading books for 10 to 12 hours, 14 hours, 16 hours. But whenever I used to ask him what is the output, I used to ask him ki questions puchta tha ki related to that book, that chapter, and he was not able to answer. He was not able to recollect. So reading is only one type of learning process, and you have to focus on writing also and listening to things. Whenever you are reading a chapter, make sure you have a book and pen in front of you. You make points out of the chapter, you make short notes, you jot down keywords and try to form a diagram, interlink diagram about this chapter. You should, at the end of the chapter, you should know ki ye chapter kya kehna chahta hai, what is the crux of this chapter. So as I said ki it's important that you read also, write also and listen also. Listening is also one of the most important way of learning. So focus on all these three concepts. The second and most important thing what students do to memorize things is they focus on visual memory, they focus on mind palaces. So most of the students have problem with respect to chronology of historical events from 1940s to 1948 of modern history. So I've met a friend and he told me a story, and he told me to visualize things in a very funny way, and I could remember that chronology still now. So the chronology was, he started with World War II and he said ki 1939 mein we had a World War II, and post that kya hua, Lahore session which happened in March. Then after Lahore session, there was August offer. After August offer, there was Cripps mission. After Cripps mission, there was Quit India movement. After Quit India movement, there was formation of Indian National Army by Subhash Chandra Bose. After formation of Indian National Army, there was the next chronological event was cabinet mission. And after cabinet mission, there was formation of interim government. So he made a story out of this in the form of March mein 1940s mein Lahore mein one of the persons started making a palace. In August, it was completed. He went into this palace in August, and after August he went into this palace and he ate crispy potatoes in this palace. He quit from the palace. After he quit from the palace, he formed an army. Once he formed this army, he went to the cabinet. After he goes to the cabinet, he forms the interim government. So ye story jo banayi thi us dost ne, it directly went into my mind. So I just want to tell you ki you have to make certain mind palaces and mind maps. The third point which I would like to focus is learning with clarity. So once you start learning with clarity, things becomes easy for input into the brain, for forming linkages within the brain, and for retrieval also. So once you make things in a simpler format, you start remembering things for longer duration. So if I give you an example, recently there was a plasma therapy in news. So the thing, what do you mean by plasma therapy? So first, aapko plasma pata chahiye. Plasma is a component of blood. So what is the component of plasma? Plasma mein kya hota hai? Antibodies hote hai. So antibodies kahan se aate hai? They come from B cells. They're also known as plasma cells. So what is the role of antibody? So if you learn with this clarity, you would be able to understand plasma therapy. So learning with clarity helps you to retain for a longer duration. It helps you to form linkages for longer duration. So ye ek important thing hai, learning with clarity. And how this clarity would come in is through research. So whenever you find a difficult concept, go into the depth of Google per search kijiye, dekhiye ki why it is formed, what is the role of repo rate, how it is linked to inflation. So until you do research, until you read with clarity, it's very difficult to retain things for longer duration. So one of the other thing what toppers do is they focus on revision. Revision mostly before going to the bed. So I had a friend who cleared UPSC with a very good rank, and his strategy was before going to the bed, he used to revise all the things which he had read in that day. So initial few days may you find it very difficult to remember everything, remember what you read in the day. But next day you become more conscious ki yaar aaj raat mein mujhe ye cheez फिर से याद करनी है. सो योर ब्रेन बिकम्स मोर कॉन्शियस वाइल रीडिंग. सो मेक अ हैबिट बिफोर गोइंग टू द बेड, यू रिवाइज द थिंग्स विच यू हैव रेड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. तो ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट एक स्ट्रैटेजी है दैट वुड हेल्प यू इंप्रूव योर मेमोरी. फॉलो दिस रिवाइजिंग स्ट्रैटेजी फॉर 10 डेज एंड आई विल टेल यू डेफिनेटली यू वुड बी एबल. वन ऑफ द अदर स्ट्रैटेजी विच मेनी ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स हु यूज टू फॉलो ड्यूरिंग एमबीबीएस पीरियड इज टू मेमोराइज थिंग्स एंड टू लर्न इन अ बेटर वे. दे यूज टू टीच अदर पीपल, दे यूज टू एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट टू अदर पीपल. सो इन दिस प्रोसेस वॉट यू डू इज यू स्पीक ऑल्सो, यू डू एक्स्ट्रा रिसर्च ऑल्सो. इफ यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन टू अदर्स, यू हैव टू रीड इन डेप्थ. You have to read in depth, and your brain becomes more active. Your brain tries to concentrate on the topic more effectively. So, is process se kya hota hai? You learn in a better way. So, explaining things to other also improves your memory. नेक्स्ट इज जो मोस्टली सारे सारे टॉपर्स बोलते हैं कि फॉर्मिंग न्यूमोनिक्स सच एज इफ यू हैव सीन इन यूपीएससी देयर सो मेनी मैपिंग रिलेटेड न्यूमोनिक्स व्हिच हैव बीन फॉर्मड with respect to Black Sea, there is a mnemonic of Gurbat. With respect to Caspian Sea, you have a mnemonic of Tariq. That is Turkmenistan, Azerbaijan, Russia, Iran, and Kazakhstan. So mnemonics is one of the ways. One more important way of learning is testing yourself multiple times. So and test series is the best way to test yourself. So बहुत सारे students आते हैं मेरे पास sir, I'm getting less marks. And I tell them you should be feeling lucky क्योंकि जिस test में आपको कम marks आते हैं उस टेस्ट के क्वेश्चंस आपको ज्यादा दिन तक याद रहते हैं वो कॉन्सेप्ट्स वो जो भी टॉपिक था वो आपको ज्यादा दिन तक याद रहते हैं तो टेस्टिंग से क्या होता है यू मेक मिस्टेक्स एंड वंस यू स्टार्ट मेकिंग मिस्टेक्स यू रिमेंबर फॉर लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन सो इफ यू हैव टू इंप्रूव योर लर्निंग प्रोसेस और इफ यू हैव टू इंप्रूव योर मेमोरी यू हैव टू टेस्ट योर सेल्फ कंटिन्यूअसली एंड बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट ये टेस्टिंग प्रोसेस से घबराते हैं एंड आई टेल देम जितने कम मार्क्स आपको मिलता है यू शुड बी हैप्पी सो आप क्या कर रहे हो आप गलती आपके मॉक टेस्ट में ही कर रहे हो यू आर नॉट मेकिंग मिस्टेक्स इन फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन तो मेक श्योर यू टेस्ट योरसेल्फ रेगुलरली मेक श्योर इट्स नॉट ओनली अबाउट हार्ड वर्क इट्स ऑल्सो अबाउट स्मार्ट वर्क तो आपको आपकी लर्निंग प्रोसेस इंप्रूव करनी है आपकी मेमोरी इंप्रूव करनी है एंड इफ यू फॉलो दिस सिक्स सेवन स्टेप्स डेफिनेटली आपकी मेमोरी वुड इंप्रूव एंड दिस स्टेप्स आर एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स